Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a simple frame animation in Photoshop. You can add as much or as little graphics in your animation as you like. Keep in mind, the animation feature isn't available in earlier versions. Make a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. I'll make the size of this document 1280 by 720 pixels with a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. You can make yours any size you like. To fit the document on your screen, press Ctrl or Command 0. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font. I'm choosing a font called False 3D. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link, which is located in the video description or project files. I'll make the size 116 points, sharp, center alignment, and black for the color. Type out your text. To increase or decrease the space between lines, go to Window and Character. The Character panel will open. Highlight the bottom line and slide the baseline shift icon to the left or right. To center your text, click on the Move tool and move it. You can close the character panel now. We're ready to add color to the text, but first we need to rasterize it. Go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. Click on the foreground color, pick a color, then click OK. Open your Paint Bucket tool and click inside your characters. If you accidentally click on another part, press Z to undo it. Repeat the process to add color for each character. Next, we'll cut and copy each character to its own layer. To do this, open your lasso tool and carefully draw around the first character. Press Ctrl-J on Windows or Command-J on a Mac to cut and copy the first character to its own layer. Make your original text layer active. Draw around the second character and cut and copy it to its own layer. Repeat this with every character. Hide the original layer and make a composite snapshot of your image by making your top layer active and pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Name it 1. This will be the first frame of your animation. Hide the layer and open your Move tool. Make sure Auto Select is checked. This allows us to move individual characters simply by clicking on them. Go to View and make sure Snap is not checked. If it is, simply click on it. Click on each character and move it slightly. Make a composite snapshot of your image by scrolling to the top of your Layers panel and making the top character layer active. Use the same keystrokes as you did earlier to make the composite snapshot and name it 2. This will be your second frame of animation. Hide the layer and slightly move each character again. Make the top character layer active, make a composite snapshot, and name it 3. This will be your third frame of animation. Continue to make as many frames as you like. For this example, I'll make 5 frames. Make all the frame layers visible. Go to File and Save As. Save it to your desktop and click on New Folder. Name it Animation. Click on the Animation folder and name the file 1 as a JPEG. Then click Save. When you see this window, make sure the quality is maximum and the slider is all the way to the right. Then click OK. Hide layer 1 and go back to File and Save As. Click Desktop and the Animation folder. Name it 2 as a JPEG. Click Save and OK. Repeat these steps for all of your frame layers. Go to File, Scripts, and Load Files into Stack. Click on this arrow and choose Folder. Click Browse and the Animation folder. Then click OK on both windows. Photoshop automatically is loading all the layers into a stack. This next step differs depending on what version of Photoshop you have. For Photoshop CS5, go to Window and Animation. For CS6 and Creative Cloud, go to Window and Timeline. At the bottom, in the middle of the panel, you'll see a button with a drop-down allowing you to choose either Create Video Timeline or Create Frame Animation. Choose Create Frame Animation. In the Animation Timeline panel menu, click Make Frames from Layers. Now we'll change the duration of each frame. Click Select All Frames. Notice all the frames are now highlighted. Click the down arrow just underneath one of the frame images. You can set a time duration for your frames. Since all frames are selected, all frames will be set to the same time. Each frame can be changed individually if you want. For this example, I'll choose 0.1 seconds. Notice all the frames have durations of 0.1 seconds. Presently, the animation is set to play once, so I'll click on the arrow next to it and choose Forever. To play the animation, press the Play button. To save it, click File and Save for Web. Make sure the file format is set to GIF. Then click Save. Choose a location to save it to. I'll save mine to my desktop. I'll name it Animation Clip. Then click Save. To open the file, just click on it. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.